have a statement.
The family of a Fil-Am who died while being restrained by police last year has filed a wrongful death lawsuit on Monday. The lawyer representing Angelo Quintil's family says they have filed a federal lawsuit against the city of Antioch and its police department.
We believe that Angelo Quintil was wrongfully killed by the police, by the manner in which they employed an illegal restraint called restraint asphyxia. Restraint asphyxiation is what happened here. And it is a real tragic deed for us and for the family, because this did not have to happen.
On December 23rd, 2020, police were called to the Quintil family's Antioch home when Angelo was going through a mental health episode. According to the complaint, one police officer pressed a knee on the 30-year-old's neck for almost 5 minutes while another restrained his legs. Quintil was reportedly unresponsive when he was taken away by paramedics. He died 3 days later. Angelo's sister Bella says the family is still looking for closure.
It hurts to remember how he went. But he believed that he had a guardian angel. And if there is something more for him, I hope that he has it.
The attorneys of the Quintil family say that based on their independent autopsy, there were no drugs in his system. The lawyers are also slamming Antioch Police Chief Tammany Brooks, who had previously defended his officers' actions, saying none of them applied any pressure to Angelo's body.
An attempt to shame the victim. This is a young man who was dead. It happened in front of his mother and sister, but yet the effort was to shame him, to suggest that he caused his own demise. And that, to me, was outrageous and despicable, because the facts are pretty clear that it was a mental case and should have been treated as such.
Meanwhile, the Quintil family has been working with city and state officials in creating a better policing system, such as installing body cameras, establishing a mental health responsive team, and supporting a bill that prohibits law enforcement to apply holds that leads to positional asphyxia.
We all need a working police system that we can trust, and that we know, and trust comes from accountability and transparency.
The Contra Costa County Sheriff's Office has scheduled a coroner's inquest for this case for August 20th to determine the official cause and death of the Fil-Am man. Ramel Conclara, ABS-CBN News, Antioch, California.